honored to be working with your students. It's really fun. We've got a great guitar program. Gosh, it's so nice to be back in person. So we've got a lot of songs for you, a lot of music tonight. So the beginning guitar, we're gonna demo some things we've been working on. Just a quick raise of hands, beginning guitarists. How many people had never played guitar before August 16th? That's almost pretty much every single person in the class, and they've been working really hard every single day, working together, learning how to play their instrument. So they've got a lot of really impressive stuff to show you. So we're gonna start with a piece called First Time Around. Guitar is unique in the fact that we read two kinds of music. We read what's called guitar tablature, and we also read treble clef normal notation, like other instruments in band, choir, and orchestra do. We have our own tablature. It's a great way to introduce note reading to students, and it allows us to play ensembles right away. So from almost the second week of school, we were playing in an ensemble setting, which is really great. Our first song is called First Time Around, and this is focusing on notes on our E string, which is this one, and our B string, which is this one. So you're going to hear us play a duo, which means we're playing two parts at the same time, and we're going to play that for you now. This is First Time Around. Trio means that there's three parts playing at the same time. We're going to introduce a new string here. We're going to introduce the D string. D string is what we call string four, and string three also. We have the G string here, and we have the D string here. Okay? So those two we're going to introduce you, and this is called Spanish Trio. We hope you enjoy. Worked on not only note reading but playing chords. As I'm sure you know, the guitar is a chordal instrument. We have six strings, we have five fingers. That allows us a lot of opportunity and leeway to play some chord stuff. So we're going to show you that. This is over Scarborough Fair. If you're a Simon and Garfunkel fan, you'll know this tune very well. This is Scarborough Fair. This is going to focus on our lower notes, on the G string and the D string as well, and showcase some of our new chords. All right, here's Scarborough Fair. Thank you. going to showcase the blues. For those of you that don't know, the blues is a really popular progression, especially for us guitarists. And we spent some time exploring the blues, the chords that are involved, and how to play some what we call blues licks over this chord progression. So you're going to hear the beginning guitar students rock out over this nice blues lick, which is cleverly titled Blues in E, because we're in the key of E, makes sense. So we're going to play in the key of E, and we're going to show you what some blues licks sound like over this key. So we hope you enjoy. This is Blues in E. Some guitars have as many as 26, 28, okay, if you're getting crazy up here. There's a lot of space for us to move up and down the neck. So with this piece, Hidden Castle, we talked a little about how to play up and down the guitar neck playing in different positions. So what I'd like you to do is check out the guitarists as they move up and down the neck for this one. This is a really fun tune. This is called Hidden Castle. Students, as you can tell, have got some developing some really awesome skills. We can start to put together a little bit more challenging pieces. So we have a couple of those that we want to showcase for you. The first one is called In the Mirror. This is going to showcase the students' knowledge of tablature on strings 4, 3, 2, and 1, and also playing some chords, what we call our open position chords. So you're going to see them strumming through that. We also talked about strumming patterns, so getting a strumming pattern, sounding together, playing the right chords, all that stuff. So you're going to see a couple chords here, E minor, A7, and D minor as well. So check out for those changes. You're going to see that from the students. as well as putting together in a trio setting some of our note reading tablature. So this is In the Mirror. We hope you enjoy it. Up to kind of our furthest progress of the semester. Again, can we just give it up one time for these students that learned how to play guitar like that? Honestly, one of my favorite classes to teach, because you go from not knowing even how to pick up the guitar and hold it to making awesome music together as a team, which is really, really fun. So we are going to demonstrate to you now. We've started to read some notes in treble clef. Like I said earlier, as guitarists, you need to be able to read tablature, but also notes in treble clef. And as the guitar ensemble members can attest to, I make sure that we read some treble clef every single day, because it's an important skill to know how to do. So we're going to demonstrate our knowledge of the E string and the B string, strings 1 and 2, with a little exercise, just called exercise number 2. But it's going to demonstrate some of our notes on the E string and the B string. We hope you enjoy it. Ensemble, but it's a really fun one, kind of culminating, putting together a lot of things that we've been doing. So this is in a tree. This is actually in a quartet. So we haven't shown this to you yet, but this is actually, you're going to hear four different parts played all at the same time. right? And this is, because it's our holiday concert, December already, I know some of you, at least my parents, start celebrating the holidays in like the second week of November. So we wanted to give you some holiday music to get you in the spirit. This is the holiday classic Green Sleeves, arranged for a guitar ensemble. So we hope you enjoy. This is Green Sleeves. Now, don't worry, we are going to come back with some more tunes from them in just a little bit. However, we'd like to present now the guitar ensemble portion of our concert. So the guitar ensemble is really unique. I don't know of a lot of high schools that have a guitar ensemble, which is one of the many reasons why Addison Trill is so awesome. But these students actually were beginning guitar students sat not too long ago. And, well, actually, some of you didn't because we were on Zoom, but right. But these students have taken beginning guitar and completed that course, and because they're awesome and they wanted to continue their guitar journey, they took guitar ensemble, and this is open to any student that takes beginning guitar, and we love having this guitar ensemble. These students work really hard every day, and this is a very much an ensemble-focused class, so everything you're going to hear today is an ensemble piece, and we've got a lot of works for you, which we hope you enjoy. So we're gonna start with a nice little chorale. A chorale is basically just a 4 to 5 part harmony put together in a key center to kind of explore that key and make some harmonies through that. So we're gonna play chorale in C for you first. We hope you enjoy. Thank you. our next piece is, I guess for all of you parents out there, you might know Peter Gunn, theme from the TV show. So this is the theme from that show. This is going to feature all of our sections, really. I'm going to be playing the bass part here for a little bit. And we hope you enjoy it. This is Peter Gunn. You in the holiday spirit with this next one. This is a really fun arrangement of this song that puts a crown on my face, one of my favorite holiday tunes. This is Deck the Halls. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
next tune is one that we've been working on for a while, one that's a lot of fun to play, a lot of fun to work on as a team. This is Nota Bene, and it's a really great Spanish-inspired piece. You'll hear those in the rhythms. There's a really, really fun percussion section that happens, so be watching out for that. We're going to kind of turn into a percussion ensemble in the middle, back half of this piece. It's just a really fun piece. We really hope you enjoy. This is Nota Bene.
Thank you.
So we even have, as Guitar Ensemble, we have one more piece for you. Because we're a guitar ensemble, we like to play the electric guitar and classical guitar. There's so many great applications and uses for the guitar. It's a really amazing instrument. So we like to play music from all different styles, genres, time periods. So you just heard a Spanish classical piece. We're going to take it to completely different, and we're going to play some Jimi Hendrix for you right now. We're going to play some Purple Haze. This is going to feature Hugo, Leo, and Polo on the electric guitar. And we actually have Jimi Hendrix's amp sound, so you're going to get a real-life Jimi Hendrix sound with this one. This is Purple Haze, Jimi Hendrix's favorite famous tune. We hope you enjoy. Give us just 1 second to transition over.
Yeah, Hugo.
Thank you.
Again, that was Hugo, Leo, and Polo. And Polo's playing with a broken thumb. He came in like 2 weeks ago and said, hey, I broke my thumb, I can't play. And then 3 days later, he's like, never mind, I can play. So he's a trooper. He's doing great. Okay, now we're going to go back and have the guitar ensemble, beginning guitar peoples join us again. We're going to do two combined numbers for you. And the first one, again, it's a holiday, so we'd like to bring it down a little bit after the craziness. That is Jimi Hendrix. We're going to bring it down a little bit with the classic holiday tune, Silent Night. And then we've got a special number for you, which will this is Silent Night. Silent Night. No! To our last song of the evening. It's been so much fun. Man, it's so great to see so many people here. Thank you all so much for coming. It's great to see friends, parents, families, and former students here. Man, it's so great to see you all here. Thanks for supporting the guitar program. We love to have you guys out here. Thank you so much. We're going to finish up with a really fun tune made famous by Santana in the early 60s, or I guess the late 60s. Late 60s. This is called Evil Ways.
By Sonny Henry.
That's right. Made famous by Santana. Thanks, Sandra. All right. You're all good. So, we are going to feature Hugo again, and then this is Kevin over here and Alberto. So, they're going to play a solo on this for you, and we're going to feature our band guitarist again. This is Evil Ways. Again, thank you so much for coming out. We hope you enjoyed your time. Can we give another one more hand for the students? So happy to have them. Hopefully all of them in guitar ensemble next year. Okay, here we go.